This is Park City, Utah, home of the world-famous Sundance Film Festival, where you'll find everything from tiny independent films to multinational marketers. The biggest names in the media business are here, and so are unknown filmmakers, hoping to be tomorrow's blockbuster stars. This week, we'll go behind the scenes with the big documentaries and the big business of Sundance. And we'll tell you about the rest of the week's biggest media stories, including the dramatic battle between the Weather Channel and DirecTV, and the debut of Sasheer Zamata, who had a lot of people laughing last night on Saturday Night Live. I'm Brian Stelter, and it's time for a special edition of Reliable Sources. There's no prompter. No prompt. Good morning, I'm Brian Stelter. We're at the CNN Lounge in Park City, Utah, where the biggest names in the film business are here. Of course, a lot of film buyers, a lot of filmmakers, a lot of ordinary film buffs as well. And we'll take you here and show you all about it coming up. We'll also talk to a few veterans of the festival who've been covering it before to fill us all in. But we want to get to a big story that developed this weekend first. And of course, it involves New Jersey Governor Chris Christie and MSNBC, the liberal cable channel. Now, Christie went to Florida this weekend. He's doing a little bit of fundraising, but he left some troubles back behind in New Jersey. Just a week after he faced news of a scandal over a politically motivated traffic tie-up at the George Washington Bridge, new claims have emerged that his office withheld Superstorm Sandy relief funds from the city of Hoboken when its mayor wouldn't support a project that Christie was backing. Now, MSNBC has led the charge on this story. And the Hoboken mayor, her name is Dawn Zimmer, provided the channel with emails and personal notes to back up her claims. Many MSNBC anchors have a liberal bent, so it's no surprise the channel has spent a great deal of time talking about Christie's various controversies. But the governor's office is fighting back. They're accusing the channel of being on the attack. In a statement on Saturday, here's what they said. MSNBC is a partisan network that has been openly hostile to Governor Christie and almost gleeful in their efforts attacking him, even taking the unprecedented step of producing and airing a nearly 3-minute-long attack ad this week. Governor Christie and his entire administration have been helping Hoboken get the help they need after Sandy, with the city already having been approved for nearly $70 million in federal aid, and is targeted to get even more when the Obama administration approves the next rounds of funding. So what's going on here? What does this tell us about cable news? Well, joining me from New York, Kate Zernike, my former colleague at the New York Times, who has covered Chris Christie extensively, and in Washington, Erik Wemple of the Washington Post. Kate, let me start with you. The Christie administration uses the word gleeful to describe MSNBC. Do you think that's a fair word?
Well, I think, look, I think in some cases, I think certainly the later evening hosts, Rachel Maddow and Lawrence O'Donnell, but did we ever, as you mentioned, did we ever expect that they were anything but liberal television hosts? I think actually Steve Kornacki, who did the story yesterday in Hoboken, has actually been pretty fair. He's well-versed in New Jersey. He started his reporting career there. So I think actually his story was fairly well reported. I think he gave a pie. Mm. He talked about the Christie administration's reaction. He pressed Dawn Zimmer pretty forcefully on, well, why didn't you come forward if this was really what you were talking about? So I think that in some cases, yeah, the network has been aggressively anti-Christie. On the other hand, again, look at the Morning. Morning Joe is still very much supporting Christie. That's where Christie has always had his real friends.
What do you think, Erik? You know, you recently spent a whole day watching MSNBC and you wrote a great blog post about what that was like. You were analyzing the liberal bent of the channel. Does a story like this just show that MSNBC is to the left what Fox is to the right?
Well, I don't think that there's an equivalency quite that way. And I think Kate basically took all the words out of my mouth. What Kornacki did was reporting. I mean, he added a significant dimension to this story. I mean, while certainly there was a lot of blather on the MSNBC airwaves this week, everybody talking about Christie and not necessarily advancing the story in terms of reporting much, Kornacki was sitting there documenting this new revelation about Dawn Zimmer. I think that's a very significant addition, and even the New York Times and just about everybody else has had to follow those revelations. So, I mean, I don't think that there's an equivalency. Fox tends to just hammer away, hammer away, hammer away. Doesn't make huge reporting splashes like this on a big story as routinely. I think this is actually a very significant and good moment for MSNBC, which of course ended 2013 on a terrible, terrible note, set of notes.
Well, with Martin Bashir, with Alec Baldwin, right. With Melissa Harris-Perry, all these various controversies, SNL, Saturday Night Live, actually brought up this latest allegation about Hoboken last night. Let's run the clip.
Well, I'm very curious about how these new allegations that you withheld Hurricane Sandy funds to punish the mayor of Hoboken.
Oh, really? You're curious? Well, let me ask you a question, Piers. How long's your drive to work?
I don't know, maybe 15 minutes?
Oh, well, that's a nice commute. It would be a real shame if something were to happen to it.
Wait, I'm sorry, Governor, are you threatening me?
I don't know. Am I?
Now, I run this clip to make the point that Christie is being raked over the coals about these various controversies. Kate, did you read the statement attacking MSNBC and perceive this as an attempt to change the topic and move it over to media bias as opposed to these actual issues?
Absolutely, and you probably can't blame them, and this is probably what other politicians would do, is change the story from being about them to being about something else, namely media bias. You know, I think Governor Christie has also shown himself really good at this. Earlier this year, there was a story locally in New Jersey about how during Hurricane Sandy, he had NJ Transit had not moved the trains into a higher ground. Anyway, Governor Christie was asked about this by one of the newspapers, and he blamed what he called a mid-level civil servant. Well, it turns out there are no mid-level civil servants at NJ Transit. So we've seen this pattern before, and what people are always looking for is patterns. The pattern here is trying to shift the blame onto someone else.
Yeah, I don't think...
They might be... Yeah, go ahead, Eric, sorry.
No, I don't think... There's also a certain naivete in the in the statement they issued. I mean, I'll watch MSNBC. We know that when something bad happens to a Republican, there will be a gleeful tone. I don't think that the Christie people help themselves at all by complaining about tone of coverage. I think America is basically inured to tone. I think what matters are the facts.
I wonder if this is going to further hurt NBC News, though. MSNBC has relationships with NBC News. NBC News would love to have interviews with Chris Christie. They'd love to have GOP debates in 2016. Eric, do you see this affecting NBC News at all?
I think there's a
high-profile possible candidate for 2016 coming out against MSNBC?
I do. I think there's a massive amount of tension between the organizations, and I think that the NBC News people I talk to are always somewhat wondrous or, shaking their heads. About the tilt and about the fact that, especially in the daytime and, into primetime as well, there's a lot of talk and not enough reporting. But as I say, I think this Kornacki thing sort of steers in a new direction. I think it's an interesting mishmash here.
Kate, I remember a story you wrote about a month ago about the image of Chris Christie being a bully. And back then, it was pretty hard to get people come on the record, wasn't it?
Right. I mean, the stories that were included in that piece were generally the pieces that were generally the elements that I had seen reported elsewhere or that I could get people to talk about. But it was incredibly hard to get people to talk because Governor Christie is an incredibly powerful governor. He appoints so many positions across the state. He's got this tremendous power of the purse, like other governors. So there's really a feeling by Democrats and Republicans that they don't want to cross him because they can get in real trouble and things will be, they will be punished. And they've seen this happen to their colleagues before. What's interesting now is that I think, MSNBC is not the only one perhaps smelling a little bit of blood in the water. I think there are other people, in the last few days I've been talking to people and their willingness to either share more or share on the record has been really striking to me. So I think it's actually a sign of how much the governor is in trouble.
Sounds like more stories to come from you and your colleagues?
I would think so, yes.
And maybe the point is that there are stories from all sorts of places. MSNBC is partisan in many ways, but that doesn't mean they can't do factual reporting. And Eric, I wonder if that's something that they may have to remind viewers or the viewers may have to come around and believe.
Yeah, well, I think that's a really good point. I don't think that we should get this notion that just because you're a partisan journalism outfit, you can't do news, you can't break news. I mean, Maddow last year had the Rand Paul thing. Now, Maddow, as we know every time we watch her, we know she has a great, a fabulously entrenched worldview. I'm not saying the worldview itself is fabulous, but anyway, she has done a lot of that. Mother Jones has National Review last year in the government shutdown. They have a worldview, of course, but Robert Cotso is out there reporting and breaking a lot of stories. So partisan outfits or ideologically leaning outfits can certainly do news. And this is a reminder. I agree with Kate 100% that the Kornacki segment yesterday, or the segments, I should say, were really good. And I think are a great reminder to all of us who think that partisan or ideologically invested journalism can't do anything on news. They can.
I do think it'll create more tension for NBC News, though. Eric, Kate, thank you both for joining us.